in this movie, I'm going to continue to talk about strengths, and I'm going to use my resource presentation from my schedule. So I'm just going to go to my homepage, go to my schedule, click on any of these links to get to the schedule for the Python course. We're now talking about strings. We've talked about lists, we're going on to strings. In a previous movie, I referred to chapter 8 and showed you some of the material in chapter 8 of the free textbook online. Now I'm going to use this resource, which is a presentation, which I'm going to open. And this is a PowerPoint. You can either open it in PowerPoint or in any open source software that handles presentations. Now let's run it from the beginning. So I've called this one on now for something quite similar, because strings are quite similar to lists. And so strings. Now a string is a special kind of list. In some ways it's like a list, in other ways it's not like a list. So I will be highlighting differences and similarities in this presentation. So introducing strings. Strings are a collection of characters in a sequence contained within quote marks. These are all examples of strings. And these are all strings. So a string could be a numerical character or characters. Strings are composed of characters contained within quote marks. Each character has a numeric code, which belongs to a set of characters known as the Unicode character set. So let's have a look at the Unicode character set. Now Unicode, it includes all the characters A to Z, the numbers 0 to 9, punctuation marks, space character, and all the other characters. Well, not all of them. But Unicode, what is Unicode? Well, let's just go back. If I go back one, how can I go back? Let's try that. Yes, what is Unicode? So Unicode, we have Unicode character charts. Now if you click on this, this is a link from the presentation. It will take you to the code charts for Unicode. Now Unicode is an organization, it's a .org, which is a charitable organization. And this organization stores all the different codes for all the different characters that are available worldwide. So it includes all the different languages, all the different graphic characters that are available on computers today. And let's go back to my presentation, if I can find it. There it is. So let's continue from where I was. Now where was I? I was here. Somebody's made a comment on my volume. Okay, thank you. I'll try and increase my volume for those of you who are having problems hearing me. So let's go to the next screen. Now Unicode character set includes the ASCII code character set. A-S-C-I-I is pronounced ASCII. And here I've got a link to the ASCII code character set. Now ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. It's been around for a long time. This is the ASCII code table. Now notice that, let's go down to the ABC. Now the ASCII code, the numerical code for the capital letter A, is 65. Now if you know your hexadecimal, 65 in hexadecimal is 41. And the code for the letter B is 66, C is 67. These are all the hexadecimal code equivalents. Now, if you are not familiar with decimal and hexadecimal conversions, you could go to my numbering system video, which explains how to convert from decimal to hexadecimal and vice versa. Now it's important that you do understand hexadecimal notation, because sometimes you need it when you're writing Python programs. So let's go back now to my slide. And so strings are contained within quote marks, and those quote marks could be single, double, or triple quote marks. This is single quote marks, this is double quote marks. If you want a string to span over several lines, including the new lines, then you could use triple single quote marks. And there are times when you might want to do that. So, of course, example programs, if you click on the link here, it will take you to all of my example programs. This one is showing you the code for 08-01.py. And now, if you wanted to print a double quote mark within a string, you could do that by enclosing your string in single quotes. And you could try typing that in and seeing, or just have a look at program 802. If you want to print a string that contains an apostrophe, then enclose your string in double quotes, and then you can include an apostrophe or a single quote anywhere in your string, and that's shown in program 0802. Now, string operations. Strings, a number is treated as a character if you contain it within quote marks. Now, you cannot perform regular arithmetic on numbers that are stored as strings, but you can repeat strings by using the multiply symbol. You can repeat or multiply strings. So, for example, string 3 multiplied by 4 results in a string 3333. And check on the example program to see that in action. Now, you can join strings together using the plus symbol or the plus operator, and this is a process known as concatenation. So here I'm concatenating this string with this string and with this string. Now, this string is multiplied by 3. Notice if your string includes a space, then that space will be included in the string and in the multiplication. And you can see that in program 08-04. Now, indexing strings using the bracket operator. Any element of a string can be accessed by indexing. So here I'm accessing index 0 and index 5. Remember, all indexes start at 0. Now, in this respect, using the bracket operator, we've used this when we use lists. So you should be familiar with using this. So this is program 0805. Now, as with lists, we can also slice strings by using the bracket operator again. And here we have a slice of this string. Using the bracket operator, we're using the range from 0 colon 1. Now, the last index will be one less than this second index. So this is actually going to access 0, index 0, which is the letter A. This slice will be from index 5 to 6, and this is index 5 and 6, so you'll get the two letters DA. And here we're printing from index 6 to index 8. It's always one less than that number. So that's the index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This space is a character, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there's your AWS, which will be printed here. This is program 0806. You can find the length of a string using len built-in function, just like you can do that the same with a list. So you can use the len function to find the length of a string. So the length of string 1 is 4, the length of string 2 is 6, the length of string 3, this is an empty string, there's nothing between the quote marks, this is the length of 0. Now, when you're printing here, it's printing the length of string 1 and ending the line with a space, not a new line. So this means that when we print these three, they'll be printed on the same line. That's program 0807. Now, I did talk about string formatting when we talked about repetition and string formatting. I've also got a separate movie on string formatting, so we can skip over the string formatting slides here. So let me go back to my PowerPoint there. I think I'll skip over the string formatting. And if you want to, you can go and see the movie or see this PowerPoint presentation. But I want to skip over this now. I've covered that thoroughly in a separate movie. And so, oh, I should. No, I'll skip over that one. Or maybe I should show you this one. Escape sequences. These are characters that begin with a backslash n within a string will give you a new line in your string. Backslash t in a string will give you a tab within a string. Now, depending on how your computer is set up, you may have 4 or 8 spaces in your tab. So when I print this, when I run this, you'll see the string is composed of the word one, followed by a new line, which will cause the next text to be printed on the next line down. Then the word two and a tab, this is a tab, followed by the word three. So an escape sequence is a sequence of two characters, always contained within a string. So it is actually a character. Its length, though, is because this is a special sort of character, an escape character, it has a length of one. And any escape character will actually have a length of one if you test it with the len built-in function. So it's a special character that allows special effects. Backslash n gives you a new line, backslash t gives you a tab, and there are other escape characters that you could use. I recommend you go to Google and search for Python 3 escape characters. And I'll just scroll down from here and let me see, escape sequences, string iteration and membership, all of these. Now I want to go to Unicode characters within a string. So I'm going to run from this slide, which is slide 40. This particular presentation has got about 50 slides, so we're at slide 40. And the remainder of the presentation talks about string methods, which I've already covered in a separate movie. So I'm just going to focus on this slide. Oh no, not this one. On Unicode characters within a string. And this is from example program 0814. So at this point, what I'm going to do is go to program 0814 and run the program to show you what happens. So let's close this and go to my example programs. Now you can link to my example programs through these links here, or you can just go to my home page and scroll down to Python and click on example programs. Now I want to search. I'll press F3 to give me a search box, which is here. And now I've forgotten, was it? It's 814, 08-14. And there it is. So there is my program that uses Unicode characters. So I'm going to copy this and let's see what it does. So I'm going to copy the entire code. And there we go. And I'll put it into my Python editor. And there it is. So let's just save this. So you can see here that I'm demonstrating printing Unicode characters. Now, for an explanation, go to this web page. So let's see if this web page is still available. Paste that there. And there it is, an introduction to Python Unicode characters. Right, now I'm not going to go through this page, I'll let you read through this, but I am going to go back to show you the charts. Now, I've mentioned the Unicode charts, and this particular chart shows you graphic characters, so I'm going to show you this page. And let's have a look at this one. So this one is showing you different, let's have a look, block elements. Now these are hexadecimal numbers, which are the different character blocks. And Now you can go and have a look at the various links here, but I'm going back to my code and I'm going to, let's have a look, and what I'm going to do here is show you how to print a Unicode character by using the Unicode escape character. And the code for a solid black block is the code, Unicode code 2588. So I am going to just, let's just delete the remainder of this. Right, so now if you look at your Unicode charts, one of the charts shows you a block, a full block, a black block, which is a black square that can be printed within a string. Let's see what happens when this runs. So let's go back to my save this code and run, and there you go. So this solid block, it's not actually black, but it's a solid block, is printed as a result of printing the Unicode character 2588. So 2588, this is a hexadecimal numeric code, and we specify that this is a Unicode code by the escape character slash u, and you follow the slash u with the code number, the Unicode code for that particular character, and then you can print out that character within the string. So slash u means what follows is a Unicode hexadecimal number. Here is the hexadecimal number, and that particular code is the code for a solid block. And now we place that solid block within the string between the words hello and out, and there it is printed in our string. Now let's see if we can have a look at some of the different charts. So I'm going to go to the Unicode charts here and let's visit some of the other charts. Now that was a graphic character, but say we want to have let's have a look at the mathematical operators. Say we want to include a mathematical operator within our string. Let's have a look at this chart. Seem to be going to anything there. Let's try. And let's have a look. Let's search here for, I don't know, let's have Chinese. Chinese. No, that's not what I wanted. Let's go back into, here we go, in the wrong search box here. So let's search Unicode for Chinese characters. Okay, so Chinese, Unicode, Unicode Chinese. Let's have a look at this one. And is anything happening here? Yes, it is. Seems to be a little bit slow. Let's try. Let's try. Try again here. Seems to have crashed. Oh no, here we go. That doesn't help me much. I'm looking for the chart numbers. This might help you, but it doesn't help me very much at all here. So let's have a look at the. Go back home. Problem with the internet here. Let's go back to our charts and maybe. Okay, let's go back to the charts here and let's see if we can find. example which would be useful. Let's try Mongolian. Let's have a look. Ah, okay. So let's now try. Ooh, we've got lots of different charts here. Let's go back to. Ooh, code charts. Okay. This must be a large chart. Page 1 of 2570. Let me have a look. Ah, okay, we do seem to have different languages here. And let me have a look. I can see a good example. Mathematical operators. Ah, here we've got a nice chart. Mathematical operators. So maybe I'll put this address so that you can click on this one. So here we've got a list of mathematical operators and their codes. Now if you click on one of these maps, hopefully, let's fit the page, automatic zoom, that's better. Right, so here you can see mathematical symbols and their Unicode code. So epsilon here, Greek character, its code is 2211. How can we print this character in a Python code? So 2211 is the code, and let's go to here and let's print 2211. So it will print an epsilon character, Greek, should put Greek character within the text. Right, let's hope this works and run. And there you go, there is epsilon. This is the character for the code 2211, which I found in this chart, which I found at this address. So if you want to see all of the code charts, then you would go to this address, select the chart, zoom in to see the symbol and its Unicode hexadecimal number, and use that number in your Python code. So for example, let's have a look if we can see some. There's all, I think all the character codes charts are here, and as you can see there are many. For example, if we want arrows, right, so now we have all the different sorts of arrow characters. So let's zoom in on this, automatic zoom. Okay, so if you want this sort of character, this arrow, which is sort of turning backwards on itself, the code for that one is 21B6, 21B6. So now I'm going to go to here and go to my Python program, 21B6. And this one will give you an arrow within the text. So let's try running this one, and here we have a turnaround arrow. So it works. So if you want to look at the chart now, the charts, I'm going to put this link into my example program page, so that when you go to the program 0814, I will replace these links with this link. Obviously these links have changed a little bit. So watch out for this new link, which will give you access to all these different charts, and select the character you want, make a note of its hexadecimal code, put the hexadecimal code into your string, and before the code put backslash u, which is the escape character, which is the character to specify that what follows is a Unicode character code. And okay, so I'm going to make a change to my example program 0814 to give you the new link, and I'll leave the video at that point.